Comes the parade, folks. Very exciting. And we have a color guard presenting the colors for us today from the VFW, along with the sheriff of Floyd County, Shannon Zeman. And there's McGruff, the crime dog. Wow, cool. Good to see McGruff out here today. And we appreciate all of our veterans and what they have done to serve our country and the freedoms that they have allowed us to have. And here comes our first parade marshal, and I believe that is Miss Susie Bell Vest.
Yes.
And we appreciate her as well for all of her hard work in our community. And then there is Mr. and Mrs. Doug Phillips. We're so glad to see them be a part of this as well.
Right. And now next is the Floyd Town Council. As you can see, these are the members with the mayor and the town council.
There's Paul and Dee LeMay and Mayor Griffin there.
Have a big truck coming through now.
Very big truck coming through. Somebody's done some work to put this float together, I can tell already.
Yes, they have.
And this is a special tractor, I believe.
It is. This is actually in memory of Marvin West, who passed away this year. As you can see on the float, there's Marvin's picture, as well as a tractor and some of his grandchildren, I believe, too.
Fantastic. It's a great-looking John Deere tractor there.
Sure
well.
Is.
Somebody has taken care of that.
And I believe that that's actually one of the tractors that was in the annual fun run, if I'm not mistaken, which we have in Floyd County every year.
That's great. Love the tractor fun run. It's great to see all the tractors go through town and a wonderful, exciting day. A parade of sorts, actually, with a longer route.
And now, as you can see, this is the Floyd County Girl Scouts. We welcome them.
Lots and they're wearing their pajamas today.
Did y'all just wake up?
I think they just got out of bed. And wearing their reindeer antlers.
That's right. And they're singing some Christmas songs. They must have gotten that from you earlier.
Folks are fired up. Get the Christmas spirit going. Come through Thanksgiving, and everybody got their bellies full, and now we're ready for going into the Christmas season. It's an exciting time of the year. I think people just are in a jolly mood and maybe share a little more kindness and love than maybe we do the rest of the year.
Right.
So,
up next we have the Floyd County Humane Society, like I was talking about earlier.
Oh yes,
with our fun four-legged friends.
Here they come. Very exciting.
I see a lot of four-legged friends out here.
Oh, wow. Some walking, some riding.
And now, folks, many of these dogs are actually available for adoption. Just call the Floyd County Humane Society, and you can pick up one whichever you want. Wow. Some beautiful dogs out here.
Some are even dressed for the occasion.
Yes, they are.
Very cool.
We have another float coming in. All right, who we got here, Matthew?
Waiting to see here. Everybody's dressed in green, I can tell
they
you
are.
That.
Looks like this Back Porch Studios.
A bunch of musicians. How about that?
All right, right here we have the Cloggers that we talked about. And
oh, yes.
As I understand, they're going to be performing right here in front of Exxon, right down the road.
Getting a little dance now.
Okay.
Making some noise with those shoes. I don't think I'm coordinated enough.
I'm not either. I'll tell you that much.
Now we have the
looks like the train
ATV
from
float.
The Moose Lodge.
Oh, wow. That first car there looks like Thomas.
Sure does.
Floyd Moose Lodge, and they do a lot of promotion for safety of our children, mm-hmm. especially safe surfing on the internet,
right.
And we appreciate their efforts in that for us.
We got a tractor from Saltis Lawn Care, driven by Matt Saltis. And then we got the little dress shop.
The little dress shop?
Yep.
Mary Gardner. And that's quite the staple in our community. And I know folks love to go down there and pick out a nice fashion for
right.
Christmas time.
And then next up, it looks like we have the Floyd County Boy Scouts.
Here come the Boy Scouts, all dressed up for the season.
Mm-hmm.
Quite the showing from the Boy Scouts today.
Yeah, it is.
Got their banners waving there. Future leaders in our community.
Right, right.
So someone in that group may be a parade marshal one
yep,
day.
That's true.
Here comes another large float. Pulled by a tractor with reindeers up front.
Right, and this looks like it's a Floyd County 4-H Club's tractor.
That's Julius Dickerson driving that tractor. So very cool float there. Like a big Santa Claus sleigh.
Yep, that's exactly what it looks like.
They got some big packages on there. I wonder if one's for me. I kind of doubt it.
Yeah, I don't know. A couple of them are getting off to hand out some candy, it looks
handing
like.
Out some candy.
And it looks like these are members of the Floyd County High School 4-H Club up on the float.
Very cool.
And up next, this is another one we were talking about, the Floyd County High School state champion teams from this last year.
Wow, nice float from the basketball team
yep.
there.
And this is the state basketball team, state softball team, and then I believe there's some individual winners on there as well.
Great. And the big buffalo. Very cool.
Yep. Great buffalo. Hello. My sister's actually on that float. And then we got the FCHS varsity cheerleaders.
Here come the cheerleaders.
And I see some JV in eighth grade as well.
I hear the band coming. Some more four-legged friends there.
Yep.
More cheerleaders there. They've opted for a ride today.
Yep. And then as you can probably hear, this is the Floyd County High School Band.
Floyd County Marching Band.
Led by Jay Derner.
Take a moment and listen in on that. They're doing a fantastic job today. Joy to the World there.
I believe that's the song, yes.
Sounds very good. Right in step.
It's great.
'Twas the night before, coming up here.
This looks like Ray's Restaurant float.
Got Got some music on that float as well.
Yeah, we do. Wow, what a float. What a float.
A little bit of Elvis there.
As you can see, they're giving out Mardi Gras beads instead of candy.
Fun. I believe that Ray and his wife, Bethel, have some ties to the New Orleans community.
Well, and a lot of their food is based on out of New Orleans or based on New Orleans food.
So. Great food down at Ray's. And we've got some classic trucks coming up here.
We do.
All decorated for the season.
Wow. Some classic cars as well.
Anybody who spent much time restoring an old vehicle as such, take any opportunity they can to get them out there. And that's exciting to see.
And luckily we have good weather today or we may not have seen any of them.
Right.
Because I know a lot of them don't bring their cars out if it's bad weather.
And I don't blame them.
I don't either.
See the Gideons there handing out Bibles. Mm-hmm. And we appreciate their efforts today. Some more classic vehicles coming through here.
Beautiful cars, ladies and gentlemen.
Lots of hours meticulously
spent
restoring these old vehicles.
Right.
These vehicles are made out of real metal.
Mm-hmm. Not like today's cars.
Not like today's cars. The Mustang sounds very good there.
Yeah, it does. But Mustangs typically do sound good.
I'm a Camaro fan myself.
I'm a Mustang fan. So.
Oh, showing off our engine there. That's great. A lot of fun for those folks.
Yeah, it is. Well, and when you spend so much time, you know, working on these cars, you gotta have fun with it.
Right.
Because if you don't, I think it's a waste of time and money. And
yeah. I mean, no one's going to see it in the garage.
Exactly.
Get it out here and show it off and have a good time with it. Lots of candy coming out there. There's a nice old Chevrolet. Need a car expert. Maybe we can hire somebody next year to help us.
Yeah, we're
with
going
all
to
the models.
Because I'm not exactly sure what these are. They're pretty.
You knew what the Mustang was.
That's well, yeah, that's true.
I believe that car may be of European descent.
Mm-hmm. Lots of car entries this year. That's a beauty.
Quite unique on the front end there.
There's somebody squealing out. Well, I think I know what we got. It looks like we have some clowns.
Oh, could that be the Shriners?
I believe it might be.
They're always a crowd favorite, I know.
You know, it amazes me how they don't get hurt doing some of the stuff that they do.
I know. Crazy. Crazy stuff there, but it's fun. It gets everybody excited.
And we do have Floyd Jeweler.
Entry from Floyd Jewelry there. Driving a nice truck. Oh, wow. We've got running water on that.
Wow.
Clown. The Kazim Temple Clown Unit, and the Shriners do such wonderful work at helping children with getting the physical care they need. I know they put a lot of money into hospitals. We're having some trouble there with the wagon, I believe.
Uh-oh. I hope that was on purpose.
I think maybe so.
Causing a lot of ruckus, these clowns.
Somebody's getting a suspender adjustment over there. Yeah, our cameraman, Matt Carr, up there, he's right on the front line, so hope he's able to get some good pictures there for us.
Yep. Looks like you got a hot dog on a leash.
Hot dog on a leash. How about it?
Very active hot dog, it looks like. It's pulling him everywhere.
I think he's pulling its leader.
Looks like we have a holdup in the parade, and if I had to take a guess, I would say it's likely because the Back Porch Studio is doing their clogging routine.
Oh, yes. They were stopping at the Circle K, I believe.
Right, right.
You do a whole lot of jumping there and not getting anywhere. Get some blue smoke from the deal, though.
Yep.
Meanwhile, the shower continues to run here.
It does. I'm sure he's soaking wet right now. Clowns are very interactive with the crowd today.
We got a guy there with a pink hair, got his eye on the situation, looks like. Got glasses big enough to qualify for windshield wipers.
Yep.
Burning some rubber.
There they are.
That's quite the interesting little ride there. I believe that must be a custom job.
I believe you might be right. And it looks like we're moving again.
Okay. Proceed down the street here, and there's a car of Shriners as well.
Yep.
Off to maybe the more safer. That gets the crowd so excited. Because you never know if the thing's going to tip over or not.
Yep. I think some of these people may be worried if they parked along the side of the road. I would be. We got some walking entries, it looks like. And this is the Floyd P. Flag. Parents, families, and friends of lesbians and gays.
A very festive tree.
Yes,
there.
They are. And then up next looks like Beaver Creek Baptist Church.
Their float is representing the very first Christmas.
Mm-hmm. As a nativity scene, I see Mary and Joseph. An angel. Some wise men behind there. Or wise women, I should say.
Sometimes with these floats, you have to recruit anyone and everyone to.
You do.
Play whatever part you need.
And we got Christmas 1900.
Christmas in 1900. Wow. Some period costumes there.
And, folks, this is tying back to the theme of the parade this year is Christmas through the years.
Through the years.
We've got Christmas 1950.
There are probably some vehicles of that model that just came through here earlier.
Oh, it's likely. We got Christmas 1970.
Wow. Check out those bell bottoms.
Wow. Lots of peace symbols there. Got Christmas has never changed. It has always been about Jesus. That's how they're coming up, finishing their parade float.
Sounds like gravel road coming this way.
Yep, it's the live music we were talking about earlier.
One of the more popular bands made up of young folks.
Right.
I got to hear those guys play at a benefit singing we did with them a while back, and I was very impressed with the talent there.
And it looks like before them we have WeCycle Center, which is consignment for, it looks like, I think kids and women. Is that right?
Yes, a very exciting venture in Floyd, and I think it'll do very well.
I believe so, too.
A great way to get rid of old children's clothes and have an opportunity to buy some new children's clothes as well.
All right, and as you can hear probably, this is Gravel Road, which is made up of all kids, actually. So we'll listen to them for a minute.
They have set up a full sound system on their float.
Yes, they have.
Quite a feat.
It's great music, great music.
And I believe the mothers of Gravel Road may be here behind them.
I believe you might be right.
Golf cart.
And this looks like a Circle T Auctions as well as Thompson's Used Equipment.
Okay.
This is their float.
So representing some used farm equipment there.
You know, something I want to point out is the trucks that these floats are being carried on. There are some beautiful trucks here in Floyd County.
Yeah. I'm sure some folks have taken some time to clean those guys
up.
Yeah. And I believe maybe a nice tractor pulling this next float.
I believe you might be right.
Hear the smokestack.
Looks like a Mini Cooper in front of that with some eyelashes on its lights.
Oh, wow. So that car has some personality.
It does. Looks like it says, Merry Christmas, Floyd County, from the Floyd County Tractor Fun Run.
Okay, so the Tractor Fun Run is represented today.
They are.
Along with the tractors following up here. An old Farmall McCormick. McCormick Farmall tractor, mm-hmm. And a John Deere.
An old Ford Workmaster.
So, as much pride in these tractors as the old cars and trucks that we saw come through earlier.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of work has been put into restoring these tractors.
Right.
A very tall tractor there, that yep. Case International.
Looks like it's pulling Reed Construction as well as R&S Stone. That's the float behind it, so those members are represented there.
R&S Stone, great place to get some gravel.
Mm-hmm.
Through the winter season, sometimes you gotta add some to the driveway.
Right.
Call those guys up. Another old John Deere.
Mm-hmm. Very good condition.
Green Acres, an old television show.
Green Acres is the place to be.
I don't have many Green Acres right now. Most of them are brown.
That's true. That's true.
Maybe in the spring they'll be green again. There's an Alice Chalmers. Another Farmall mm-hmm. tractor.
A little bit different than the one we saw earlier.
An even older John Deere there. That one may look even more like Green Acres.
A couple John Deeres. Very nice tractors. Another John Deere.
There's the other vehicles that might not would be here if the weather weren't so so nice.
That's true. I see quite a few flags coming up here. I'm very interested to see what these flags are. After all these tractors come through.
Got another float here.
With some music, it sounds like, again. Looks like new beginnings.
New beginnings.
Wow.
And
got some music and dancing happening.
Little dance team there.
Wow. That's great. Looks like some different flags. Got the Virginia flags and then a couple Confederate flags.
Very old flags there.
Mm-hmm.
And some period dressed in some period costumes there.
Right.
Looking very much from the Civil War era.
Mm-hmm.
I'm kind of thinking there.
We got an old cannon, it looks like, behind them. Indeed. Another big float. Lots going on here.
Wonder if that was maybe Sons of the Confederacy.
May have been.
And Daughters. Maybe there's some of those groups out. Quite active.
Mm-hmm.
I hear some rescue vehicles
I
coming
do.
Up there.
Looks
little
like
stall in the parade here.
Yep.
We wait for traffic to begin moving again. It's kind of creeping there.
Looks like we're moving again. Great looking float there.
Very cool float. Lots of work gone into that.
It's like Wills Ridge Supply. Okay.
We had to wait to kind of see who that one belonged to. Very nice job, though.
Then we got Citizens trailer here.
Here comes the Citizens 100th anniversary float.
Right.
Serving Floyd for surrounding areas for 100 years.
Mm-hmm.
And those folks look excited.
And that's driven by Ben Zimmerman, Citizens' newest employee. And then we look like we have the snow court. We got junior attendants Tori Bergman and Savannah Duncan.
We got B&T Lawn Care and Landscaping
mm-hmm.
coming up there.
Pulling a float behind them as well.
Interesting note there on that Citizens float, Casey.
Mm-hmm.
The big cake is made out of old telephone cable reels.
Okay.
So we stacked those up and covered them up and make them look like a big birthday cake.
Right.
So.
As you can see, we got the Citizens logo in the front and the 100-year logo in the back.
Quite a feat. We actually have a number of businesses in town that have been around for
right.
100 years or maybe a little more or not too far behind.
Right.
And the Citizens, the telephone cooperative was formed from a number of smaller cooperative phone companies that came together to form
right.
one large cooperative back in 1914.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll be celebrating that actually in February.
Right.
So.
And it was actually formed, the first Citizens was actually formed right here on the steps of the courthouse.
Yes.
Yeah, back in 1914.
Just a few steps from where we're actually standing.
Got some more classic cars, it looks like. four-wheelers and maybe a unicycle.
Oh, wow. Talking about not being coordinated, I know I couldn't do that.
Me either.
A little lull in the program here, but quite the coordinated youngster there on that unicycle.
And riding it downhill right now.
Yes.
That's impressive.
Do some
as well.
Work, and not to mention traffic stopping in front of you. Balance, I believe, would be the key there.
And I obviously don't have any.
And here comes another Christmas parade float. Looks like it's being sponsored by McNeil Real Estate.
And as you can see on the side, they're paying homage to the Christmas through the years again. All right, and then we have more members of the snow court. This looks like the senior attendance. We have Michaela Beckner and Lindsay Janney, everyone.
Okay.
Senior attendance for the Floyd County High School winter snow court. And then we have the snow queen right behind us, Snow Queen Taylor Jo Thompson. Who's actually the drum major for the Floyd County High School Band. And you obviously didn't see her there earlier.
I had to kind of give up duties. You can't really quite march in that dress, I don't think.
Right. We got Merry Christmas from Nichols Brothers Exhaust and Auto Repair.
Now we got a group of ATVs here.
Driven all by kids. I'm glad the cops are later in the parade, because I don't know.
Yeah, one of the chances, one of the few chances to legally drive one down Main Street.
Yep.
And got an old lawnmower there.
Oh, Cub Cadet. That.
Souped up version.
Got lots of walkers now. This is entry number 42, everyone. And it looks like this is says Merry Christmas from Faith Baptist Church.
All right, so another church group there. Mm-hmm. Got lots of folks out to ride that float, looks like.
Right. And it looks like coming up behind them, we have this year's 2013 Floyd County High School football homecoming king and queen, Kerry Martin and Billy Quesenberry.
Very cool. We broadcast that live when they were crowned.
We did.
On Citizens Channel 20 and Fort Chisholm Channel 23. Mm-hmm. And also on live stream.
Riding in a very beautiful Corvette.
Ah, see, now we'll pay homage to the Chevrolets.
Yep.
Nice color. Kind of goes right along with the Floyd County colors there. Now see, here's the Camaro.
Yep.
I knew someone had to have a Camaro for us today. Nice T-top there.
And folks, I just want to point out that the tags on that Corvette actually say farm use. So even if you have a beautiful car, you still have it farm use somewhat in Floyd.
I guess you could maybe get a bale of hay in there or some,
possibly
some animal feed.
Another classic car.
Old classic car there with some riders in the back there.
And it looks like the next float is from Slate Mountain Church.
All right.
Have another nativity scene, it looks like.
Oh, here comes
the
jolly
old ladies and gentlemen.
Man himself, Santa Claus. Very exciting to see Santa Claus today. Mm-hmm. There he is, folks, the jolly man himself. Yep.
Lots of gifts below him. And one of those could be ours.
Could be. He has a mailbox there for wishes. Still time to get those wishes in. plenty of time, actually.
Right. And I want to take a moment right now to mention that Citizens actually has a direct line to Santa Claus.
To the North Pole?
Mm-hmm. You just dial 745 in pole, and you leave a message for Santa Claus, and if you want, he can call you back.
Yeah. Pretty exciting mm-hmm. to have an opportunity to talk directly to Santa Claus himself.
Right. Looks like we have Jolly's Classic towing.
Yeah.
Out of Meadows of Dan.
Very large tow trucks mm-hmm. there. Very cool.
And as you can hear, we have Floyd County Rescue coming up next after that.
Like the crash truck there leading the way.
Mm-hmm.
And no fear there. I believe they do leave a couple of ambulances available. In case there were an emergency,
right.
So all the ambulances aren't here today, but they've got them out all shined up and looking mm-hmm. very nice. Quite the large stocking being towed there on that truck.
That's true. Fit a lot of good stuff in there.
I hope it's not coal. I don't know this, but I'm going to assume maybe the fire department behind them.
I would say you're probably right.
Guess. Again, we appreciate all the hard work these folks do for our community.
Right.
They spend countless hours not only running calls but getting training
right.
and staying up to date so that they can help in time of need. And
exactly.
boy, do they. So thankful for these guys and gals. There's a husband and wife team,
mm-hmm.
Paul and Jasmine Robertson.
Right.
And I believe maybe there are several husband and wife teams.
That's what I say. I believe there are a couple, yes. You know, I think that's one thing I love about Floyd County is that, you know, you have a lot of these couples that do the same sort of thing. And they're a lot, like with the rescue squad and as well as the school systems, there's a lot of husband-wife teachers.
Very family-oriented community. I believe those folks have fun running those sirens.
I believe you're right.
There's Jasmine's mother,
mm-hmm.
Ann Boyd.
Right.
And Pat Bishop there. I know she's a lifetime member.
Okay.
She's been on the rescue squad for years and years. And my guess was correct.
Yep.
The rescue squad is followed up by the Floyd County Fire Department. And again, these are volunteers.
Right.
These are folks who get up in the middle of the night when we're asleep in our beds mm-hmm. to help those that are in need.
Right.
Some guys dressed up in full fireman
mm-hmm.
gear. Quite a job just to put all that on. So.
Yep. Probably an even bigger job to walk in it down
probably
the spray.
So. And got their families involved in
mm-hmm.
that today. And check out the old fire engine.
Wow.
County Volunteer Fire Department. front of that engine. Very cool.
Hope they don't stop suddenly. That might be bad.
All kinds of trucks. You can see there what kind of equipment it really takes to even fight a fire. All different types of fires. Brush fires. Mm-hmm. House fires. Here is the one of the newer trucks that the department has.
Right.
I believe this truck is stationed in Williston. It is a water truck.
Okay.
And I believe that thing holds, I forget how many thousands of gallons that truck holds, but it gets called on even for areas around close to us to bring water because that truck is dedicated to nothing but carrying water.
Wow. Wow.
So a very nice tool to have. Centrally located there in Willis. Mm-hmm. To be accessible. Again, like I said, not just for our county. I was actually at a house fire one time, and I remember that truck being brought. So it reduces the number of trips that have to be made to a pond or a creek somewhere to get water when you can bring a truck that's full of water like that.
Okay.
So, nice tool to have in the fleet.
Right.
And they do such a nice job at keeping these vehicles maintained as well.
Right.
Because you know, during a fire, they have to get dirty and muddy at times, but they bring them in and get them cleaned right back up, and they look so nice.
Right.
And I'm thankful that we have the traditional red still.
Me too.
Lots of localities have different colors on their trucks now, but we still have a predominantly red fleet. And, it just seems fire truck to me.
I agree. And it looks like we have actually a Christiansburg fire truck.
Oh, wow.
Which it's great to see them come all the way to Floyd County.
To spend some time to come over here and show off there. Quite a nice ladder truck.
Uh-huh.
Something that we haven't previously had a need for in town, but I know a ladder truck was discussed when the hotel decided to build a four-story building.
Right.
So I'm not sure what the decision is on that yet, but maybe we could get these guys to come in and help us if we needed it.
Exactly.
And the sun has almost gone over the top of
it is.
Farmer Supply there.
Yep.
So sunglasses have come in handy today. It's been a nice, I believe the temperatures have been in the 50s.
I believe you're right.
So.
Not much wind. It's very nice. Very nice.
Very nice day. Appreciate those guys coming up from Christiansburg.
And as you can see, it says we have a tractor now. It says this event is proudly sponsored by Floyd County Merchants and Businessmen's Association.
Okay.
And that's Susan Leonard back there in the back.
So the parade director riding there. Appreciate her and the Merchants and Businessmen's Association.
Right. For all that they do, not only the parades.
Yes, throughout the year. They don't do it to, pad their own pockets. This is all for the community.
Right.
All for everyone else. And lots of hours.
It looks like we have some horses behind them, which is great. Beautiful horses.
Love the horses. Younger and older riders alike. Mm-hmm. Horses are all dressed up for the season as well.
Yes, they are.
Yeah, we have another little lull here, so have a little whoa moment there for the horses.
You know, that's something, to me, it amazes me, having horses like that in parades, because you never know, what they're going to do.
Right. Got sort of an unpredictable situation there, but
I'm sure with the case here, probably a lot of training has gone into making sure.
Right.
You might not pull out the horse that hasn't had a whole lot of training for this event.
Yeah, I'd imagine these are probably older horses. Yeah.
Correct. You got a horse-drawn wagons coming up as well.
Mm-hmm.
Still have some old wagon trains that come through the community every now and then, especially through the summer months.
Mm-hmm.
And some of those can be miles long, it seems.
Right. Sutphin Stables.
And they have some beautiful horses, and they take their horses all over and show them.
Okay.
And
it looks like that is possibly the end of the
parade.
That's
the end of the parade. So what a wonderful time it's been. Lots of great entries.
Right.
And everybody's excited to have seen their family and friends come through the parade, and now they're ready to make the rush home. So, once again, another parade complete.
Right.
And we thank you for joining us for this event.
Mm-hmm.
And, again, stay tuned to Citizens, Channel 20 and 23, and also Analog Channel 2, and YouTube, and the Internet.
Right.
A great way to get out there and see that content.
Right.
So tell your friends and neighbors, watch the Christmas Parade and Floyd County High School Sports and Fort Chiswell High School Sports.
Mm-hmm.
And lots of other events. The community show that Casey hosts airs weekly. So just stay with us at Citizens, and we appreciate you. And we hope you have a Merry Christmas.
Yeah, thank you.